Kabai. And yes, right? Yes, so the long dress, it was a kabai. And in the later times, with the change of times here, what did the baker started wearing? A shirt and a short trouser. And even now, people think that people who are there in Goa wearing these short trousers, they are bakers. Okay. And what about the baker's health? What does it mean, a jackfruit-like appearance? Plump, fatty appearance. And he says that those who are bakers and the people who work with the bakers, they could never starve, right? Because there was always enough to eat. What about the importance of bread in the lives of the Goan people? Yes, so bread they would eat every day because the baker would come in the morning. How many times did the baker come?
Two times.
The baker came twice. So once in the morning and second, of course, when he had finished there with his, you can say, sale, right? And how would he announce his arrival? By the, yes, the jang jang. So that's the best part of this chapter. Everybody remembers this, isn't it? So the jang jang of the bamboo stick. Why have we left these benches vacant? We love to sit two on a bench. Get up, please. Move there. What's your name? Anitej. Dhruv, you also come here. Safety always first. If you're able to see, find a vacant bench, sit there first. If you can't, then we'll see of sitting with our friends. Okay? Right, Amritpa? Yeah. Bench khatam ho gaye the. Oh my God, it's the end of the benches. Right, full stop. No more benches coming. Okay, fine. Then, yes, so how would he announce his arrival? By the thudding of the bamboo stick. And what were the children's reactions? What did they love about the arrival of the baker? Sorry, the peder, yeah. Yes, so were they worried about the loaves? How many loaves to buy for the house? No, they wanted the bread bangles, okay? Yes, so they would. And how eager were they? What about hygiene and all? What about brushing the teeth? They would not brush their teeth. So they wanted to have those bread bangles before they would finish. And they thought, yes, that the tea, you know, after that, it would wash away there. Yeah, the mouth. Right, okay. Nice thing, Drew? Is it? Do we do that sometimes? Honest people, tell me. We have done it. Okay, we have very one honest answer. Okay, so no? Right. So there are some people are very particular about it. I have to brush my teeth before I have. And some people, okay, midday mein yaad aata. Oh, I didn't brush my teeth only. Isn't it? Is there anyone like that? Must have happened. Sometimes when you're not well or something, there are exceptions. Isn't it? Right? Okay, then, yes, yeah. What about the importance of bread and cakes in on the important occasions? Yeah, so no function was complete without that. So cakes there, sandwiches and an engagement. So there were other kinds of bowls there. Bowls are like, you can say, breads or biscuits, you know, you can say. So bakery is a very, very important part of the bowls and bulinas, a sweet cake, right? So all this was an important part. Then, yes, what about money? Yes, how would the baker collect the money? At the end of the month. And yes, so did he keep a very formal record of it? No. Where was the record kept? On the wall, okay? Right, so with a pencil, you would note down. And yeah. So what does it tell about the people over there? Were they very materialistic? Were they very materialistic? Or was it, yes, it was this bonding and this feeling of togetherness that they never felt the need, okay, that I have to keep a very, you can say, rigid account of everything, isn't it? So it was there as a society, how close-knit they were and how much trust and faith they had, right? So no one's going to lie about how many loaves of bread they have consumed, and the baker will never ever be in a loss, okay? Right? So times have changed. Do you think that these things are still over there? Bread is still a part? Yes? Do you think it would be still, you know, sold in this way? With the jang jang and all, no, it would not be. So things have changed. So you have bakeries there coming up and people there according to their choice. And of course, do you think any kind of credit is given to them that, okay, we'll just settle the account at the end of the month? No. So it is there. Immediately everything is there. So the financial matters sorted out. Okay. So I'll come to that. Yes, here. Now, please look at the next page. These are very good questions here, which we have. Which of these statements are correct? Okay. Yes. Go through them. The painter was an important person in the village in old times. Yes or no? Yes. Painters still exist in Goan villages? Yes, bakers are still there. They do. The painters went away with the Portuguese. No, they're still here. Bakers are still there. And of course, yes. The painters continue to wear a single piece. No, they don't. They have changed their attire, right? Bread and cakes were an integral part of Goan life in the old days. Yes, even now also, but nothing has been mentioned. Let us look at this statement only. Traditional bread baking is still a very profitable business.
Yeah.
No?
Yeah.
Yes, it is still. So painters and their families starve in the present time?
No,
because they didn't starve then and they're not going to starve now also, because bakery is still an important part of our life. So is bread an important part of life? How do you know this? Okay. Now take the right answer. I'm not doing subjective answers with you. I'm just going through it. So you like, maybe it could be your understanding part. Let's see. The next question, question three, please. What is the tone of the author when he says the following? Tone. This whole paragraph or this whole description that he has written. Yes. What is the tone? Okay. What is nostalgic? What does nostalgic mean? What does nostalgic mean? Yes, Raghav? Yes? It is, they're talking about the past. But here, we're talking about the past in what kind of a manner? Is it happy, sad, what? Is it sad? Yeah, funny, happy, there. You know, you're reliving those moments. So like, what would be a nostalgic moment for you? What would bring up nostalgia for you? When you talk about your not a very past childhood. Yes, your childhood memories. Maybe when you talk about your nursery class or yeah, maybe you talk about your first birthday and all. How are you going? You think of it with a smile on your face. Happiness. Yes. So nostalgia is that. So what is nostalgia? Talking about the past in a very pleasant way. Okay. Right. What is hopeful? Hopeful. Full of hope, optimism, right? Yes, optimism for the future, hopeful there. Okay, sad. We all know what is sad. So what is the tone here? The thud and jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo can still be heard in some places. It's nostalgic, right? It still can be heard. And how you would love to hear that? Because it was going to bring back childhood memories. Okay, nostalgia. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. Yes. Why not sad? Why not sad? Hopeful, yes, because there is positivity, isn't it? Right? With a tinge of optimism. Yes, class. I still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves. This is pure nostalgia, absolute nostalgia. And you know, like, yes, so as you're going to grow older, there are going to be certain things that are really going to bring, you know, those nostalgic and happy moments, you know, immediately bringing a smile on your face. And sometimes you won't realize it, but most of our happy memories, you know, because we're such foodies, they revolve around food, isn't it? So you might remember that, okay, that Sunday morning when your mother would make a special breakfast, right? Or your favorite lunch, isn't it? So that is what? Nostalgia. So here he said, yeah, bringing that typical fragrance. The tiger never brushed his teeth. Hot tea could wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. It is funny. Yes, he's funny. Cakes and bolinas are a must for Christmas as well as other festivals. It's a matter of fact. It's very, you know, like, yeah, it's an opinion that he's giving. Yes. Next is the baker and his family never starve. They always look happy. And yes, once again, it is matter of fact. Yeah, it is matter of fact. They've never come across any baker starving. It's never happened. So it is matter of fact because they always can make something or the other for themselves. They like that. Okay. So let's move on to the next part. I'm not discussing all this. I'll come to this later on here. So we are looking at these passages entirely from a factual point of view. These are entirely factual passages. I will be sharing with you your informative or what you call your case study paragraphs. Okay. Right. बिल्कुल आएंगे तो हमारी केस स्टडी बिल्कुल डिफरेंट है. आई विल शेयर इट टुडे. किसके बारे में? नहीं, यू विल नॉट बी गेटिंग दैट. यू माइट बी गेटिंग डेटा, राइट, एंड इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ दैट डेटा. दैट इज फॉर यू. योर इन्फोग्राफिक्स, दैट इज, यू विल बी गेटिंग दैट. ओके, सो आई विल शेयर वन एग्जांपल विद यू ऑल टुडे. ओके, राइट. So now, Coorg is coffee country, famous for its rainforests and spices. Have you heard about Coorg? Have you heard about Coorg? No, it's a very west, yes? Famous, just now we read it, it's famous for coffee. Generally, when you talk about coffee, you know, which place you think is famous for coffee? So we generally talk about, yeah, like, yes? Yeah. Assam has coffee also. Assam has coffee, or is it known for its tea plantation? Tea as well as coffee also. We're going to find out. Next chapter is about tea and coffee. Don't worry. We're going to find out about that. Huh? Okay, right. Is it so Karnataka when we talk about? So where is Coorg exactly? Let's see. Midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore sits a piece of heaven that must have drifted from the kingdom of God. Now, beautifully written, isn't it? So where is this place? Where's Mysore? Where is Mysore? Karnataka, isn't it? So you talk about the Mysore Palace. What's the capital of Karnataka? Mysore is the capital of Karnataka. No, it's not Amravati. It's Bangalore. Bangaluru. Okay, yeah. So this land of rolling hills is inhabited by a proud race of martial men, beautiful women, and wild creatures. Martial men. Martial. Martian. What's the difference? Martial means? Martial arts, when you talk about martial arts. Fighting. So what kind of men are they? Warriors, right? Where else can we find martial men? In the army, okay, very nice, very good. Otherwise, also many parts of India, wherever, like, of course, there have been struggles and there have been wars, and the people have been involved in those. Right? So, martial here, yes, these people are very typical of that, that they belong to this very martial race, okay? Beautiful women and wild creatures. Okay, so where is Coorg? Somewhere between Mysore and Mangalore. Coorg, it's Mangalore. Mangalore is different. Bangalore is different. Don't confuse the two. Okay, we always think here in Bangalore likhna tha, Mangalore likh diya. Nay, it's not a misprint. It's absolutely there. Mangalore is also. Okay. Yes. See, it is. Mangalore is not in Karnataka. I think it's not in Karnataka. No, it is not there. I don't think so. Okay, let's see. We'll find out. Coorg or Kodagu, the smallest district of Karnataka, is home to evergreen rainforest, spices, and coffee plantations. So we had discussed yesterday also that what do you think that India has gifted to the world? Spices is one thing, right? We also talk about coffee and cotton, right? Other things, and tea also. Yes, so it's home to evergreen rainforests. So where there are evergreen rainforests, what else do you think is there?
Tea.
Always green. The forests are always green. So tea will also be there? Not necessarily. What else? Rainforest. Evergreen rainforest. Rubber. Okay. Yeah. Hardwood. Coconut. Rain. वो tropical में नहीं होगा वो. हाँ. Plants नहीं होती. Species कौन सी क्या होती? हाँ. Sunlight में आती है. So rainforest, some when you talk about the Amazon rainforest and things like that, we also talk about a lot of biodiversity, don't we? Yes. So you talk about rainforest. Tabhi upar line kya hai first paragraph mein? Last line. Wild creatures. So where will those wild creatures be? The rainforest. Okay. Right. Yes. Spices and coffee plantations. Evergreen forests cover 30% of this district. During the monsoons, it pours enough to keep many visitors away. Is it safe to travel during the monsoons? No. Right? So why? Because naturally, it is lots of landslides could be there. Your flight delayed, a problem in reaching a destination. Right? So the problems there caused by the rain. The season of joy commences from September and continues till March. What do you think is the season of joy? Season of joy. What happiness? If you want to visit that place, so that is the best time to visit from September to March. And generally, most places you see across the country, the best place time is September to March or October to March when the weather becomes pleasant. Okay? Right. The weather is perfect with some showers thrown in for good measure. The air breathes off invigorating coffee. You've seen coffee powder, isn't it? Don't we think that, yeah, we just open your jar and instant coffee is this. Have you seen coffee beans? Yes. Have you seen coffee beans? Have you smelled those coffee beans? Very strong, aren't they? Right? So what do you think is invigorating? What does invigorating mean? The air breathes off invigorating coffee. What is it? Invigorating. Strong smell, is it? So when you get that strong smell or you smell that coffee, what happens to your senses? Active, yes. It makes you active. Very nice. Good. So coffee estates and colonial bungalows stand tucked under the tree canopies in prime corners. So where are the coffee estates and where are the colonial bungalows? Where are they tucked? Tucked means under the hidden, right? Where are they hidden? Under the canopy of the forest. What is the canopy then? What do you think a canopy means without looking at the books? Can you tell me what is the canopy? The cover? Yes, so the tree is making that cover and that is there. What do you think is colonial bungalows? Britishers ke type. So what kind of bungalows would they be? Big bungalows, right? Okay, right, okay. So yes, so coffee estates and colonial bungalows, where would they be hidden? Under the canopy, the tree cover, okay? Yes, silence, someone is talking. The fiercely independent people of Coorg are possibly of Greek or Arabic descent. Wow, how did this happen? They are of Greek or Arabic descent. So where did the Greeks come from? Where did the Arabs come from? Let's see. As one story goes, a part of Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled here when return became impractical. So we've read about Alexander coming and yes, trying to conquer and how his army was defeated and some of the soldiers, they stayed back. So the Greek soldiers, Alexander was Greek or Arab then? Greek, right? So yes, so Greek soldiers, they stayed behind and that is how we have the people of Greek descent, okay? Right? So where did the Arabs come? These people married among the locals And a culture is apparent in the martial traditions. Martial traditions are war, right? The manner of fighting, the war, the martial traditions, marriage, and religious rites. Rites. What do you think it means here? Rites means? What does rites mean? Rites are traditions. Absolutely correct. Yes, religious and marriage and religious rites, which are distinct from the Hindu mainstream. So this is here. So how do we know that these people are different? What is it that makes them different? Their traditions, right? And especially the marriage customs that they have, their manner of fighting, it could be the weapons they use, the way they fight, that is, they're different. And this shows, yes, a reflection of their which descent? Greek descent, exactly. Now, where does the Arab descent come from? The theory of Arab origin draws support from the long black coat. Oh no, another long black coat. With an embroidered waist belt worn by the Kordavus, known as kufia. It resembles the kufia worn by the Arabs and the Kurds. So where can we infer that there is an Arabic connection from the dress? What is that dress? It's a long black dress, right? And yes, it resembles the kufia which is worn by the Arabs, okay? Right, so just right now, we also read about a black long dress that was known as the kabai. This is the, okay, but when we do these chapters together, then there is a bit of a confusion. So you have to remember who wears which dress, okay? So Kurgi homes have a tradition of hospitality and they are more than willing to recount numerous tales of valor related to their sons and fathers. So they're very hospitable, right? So it is quite a favorite tourist destination also, right? And the people there, they're very hospitable and they talk about their tales of bravery, okay? Right? Because it's a martial race. The Kurg regiment is one of the most decorated in the Indian army. Kurg regiment. So what do you think this regiment has? Soldiers from the Kurg region, isn't it? Right? Silence here. What other regiments do you think are there in the army? Have you ever wondered? Sikh regiment. Very nice. Okay. Yes. Yes, President's Home Guards. Is it a regiment? Is it? Okay, so we have Punjab regiment, we have Maratha regiment, isn't it? Right? There's so many regiments there. Okay, so and yes, so the Kurg regiment is one of the most decorated in the Indian Army. What does this mean? Decorated, most decorated. General Kariappa was a Kurgi. And Kurgis are a martial race. And the regiment they belong to is most decorated. That means it's got a lot of honors, right? Battle honors, okay? Yes. So even now, Kordavus are the only people in India permitted to carry firearms without a license. Do you think if it happened in Punjab, people carrying firearms without a license, what would happen? We still have a habit, you know, any festival, any celebration, okay, go. Right? Fine. Then what happens? We land in trouble. But look at these people here. Even though they're very martial, right? Very highly decorated regiment, they're the Kurg regiment. But the people, they know that, yes, if we have license, right, without arms, we can keep without a license. They also know how to behave also decently. Very important, isn't it? Okay. The river Kaveri obtains its water from the hills and forests of Kurg. Mahaseer. Silence, Amritpal. A large freshwater fish abound in these waters. Kingfishers dive for their catch, while squirrels and langurs drop partially eaten fruit for the mischief of enjoying the splash and the ripple effect in the clear water. Elephants enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mahouts. So now we talk about the wildlife. Yes? What about the freshwater fish? Which is the most popular freshwater fish? Mahaseer. Okay. And what animals are there quite common? Yes, so we have the squirrels and the langurs. Okay. And elephants also? Right. Okay. And yes, here. Yeah. So we see them there enjoying the fruit and jumping around in the water there also. The most laid-back individuals become converts. What's a laid-back individual? Lazy person. Most laziest person when he goes to Kur becomes very active. Why? To the life of high-energy adventure with river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing, and mountain biking. What are all these here? River rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing, mountain biking. They are adventure sports. Okay, right. So what is river rafting? Rafting in the river? What's a raft? What kind of a boat is it? Water boat. Oh, really? Oh, nice. How intelligent. Yes? Raft is made by tying planks together. So river rafting. So where is, do you think river rafting takes place? Rishikesh is famous for that. Very good. What about canoeing? What's a canoe? What's a canoe? It's also a small, narrow boat and elongated kind of a boat. And it is in a raft. I think so a couple of people can sit, but here it is maximum two people. So it's a long, narrow boat. So canoeing there. What is rappelling? What is rappelling? Rappelling kya hota? Adventure sport hai. Huh? Bungee jumping kaise hota? Is it like bungee jumping? Yeah. What is rappelling? Like one end of the bank to the other bank, from one bank to the other, and there's that so that rappelling is there, right? So they make you go there. Have you ever tried it? Anybody been brave enough? Okay, we have one brave person. That's nice. Okay, so somebody said bungee jumping. Can you have bungee jumping near the water? Is it? Can we have it? Hosat hai? People, they fall into the water, then come out. That is bungee jumping. What is bungee jumping then? From a height, yes. And right. So generally it is done from a high altitude. It can be done near a river, but you don't naturally fall into the water. Nikku Park mein bungee jumping hai? Okay, really, that must be so dangerous. Very dangerous it might be. Rock climbing. What is rock climbing? Pahado pe chadhna is rock climbing? Oh, wow. Then what is mountaineering? What is rock climbing? Adventure sport once again. And sometimes, you know, that it is recreated also for you. So, yeah, like that surface is there. So, you can climb the rocks also. Okay? Yes, sir. And all these here, mountain biking. Mountain biking? Biking on the mountains, okay, right. So and those who are not adventurous, who don't want to go for these adventure sports or rappelling and all, what can they do? They can do trekking. So numerous walking trails in this region are a favorite with trekkers. Birds, bees, and butterflies are there to give you company. Would you like to have the company of these birds and bees and butterflies? No? Right? Macaques, Malabar, squirrels, langurs, and slender loris keep a watchful eye from the tree canopy. So macaques, monkeys, okay? Right? You're kind of a monkey. So your loris is also kind of a rodent, Okay, right. So they keep a watchful eye from the tree canopy. So what's the canopy here once again? The tree cover. Yes. Okay. I do, however, prefer to step aside for wild elephants. Otherwise, what will wild elephants do? They'll trample you, isn't it? So you have to move away to stay away from the elephants. Now, the climb to the Brahmagiri Hills bring you into a panoramic view of the entire misty landscape of Coorg. A walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64-acre island of Nisargadham. Okay, we'll continue this, or rather.